is one of the most grueling sports in the world. Being fit is a given. But what does it really take to rise to the sport's elite level? We are taking six of Australia's very best from other sports and pitting them against our greatest Ironmen. In the name of science, we will push them to and beyond their limits. Gut-wrenching tests in both the laboratory and on the beach. Then the finale, a race to determine who just might make it as an Ironman. This is the Nutri-Grain Sports Star Challenge. Here we are at one of Australia's favourite tourist destinations. These are 12 of our favourite athletes. What awaits them is the unknown.
I always thought the Ironman was very demanding and something that I would never try my hand at.
Welcome to the sunny Gold Coast, the perfect place to put your feet up and relax. But for you six elite sports people, there'll be no relaxing this week. We're going to team up three elite sports people with three Ironmen each week.
I was pretty excited. You know, any chance to challenge myself in someone else's sport is a great challenge.
By the end of these 2 weeks, we'll work out who is best suited to be an Ironman. It's going to be quite a couple of weeks.
When I got the call, I said yes straight away. It's going to be good fun.
We will be taking you to the lab to be tested at Bond University. We will be pushing you guys to your limit and beyond.
You challenge yourself against athletes from other codes and other sports. It's really good.
You guys might be able to throw or kick a ball, but I think you're going to be in for a real shock. I'm going to be at the beach taking you through the Ironman skills.
I think it's really awesome to see some of our best Australian athletes in all different kinds of sports coming together and giving it a go.
Let's start off. Simon Kadich down here, former Australian opening batsman. You are with a multi Nutri-Grain winner. Kai Hurst, dual Olympian and four-time Australian Ironman champion.
I'm Simon Kadich, former Australian test cricketer.
Simon played 56 test matches, highest score, 157.
Every sport has an element of mental toughness. It's about being able to perform under pressure when the pressure's on.
I was eyeing him off, I was going, oh, he's about my age, maybe a little bit older, so we're the veterans of the whole group. He's a legend.
Kurt Gidley, you are going to be teamed up with Tannen Linden. 22-year-old Tannen Linden is a former Australian junior Ironman champion.
This is a dream come true. I'm still pinching myself. It's crazy.
Kurt Gidley, Newcastle Knights.
Kurt Gidley is 32 and still one of the fittest in the game.
We have to play for 80 minutes, short break at halftime. You've got to be physically fit, strong and mentally tough.
And of course, from the Sydney Swans, Lewis Jetta, Kendrick Louie, the big Manly Sea Eagles supporter. Kendrick Louie, runner-up in the 2012-13 Nutri-Grain Series and another former national junior champion.
Lewis Jetta here, Sydney Swans AFL, and I play with midfield.
Lewis Jetta, renowned for his speed and skill.
When I got read out, I was with Lewis Jetta. I was pretty pumped. He's a great bloke. He's extremely determined. The talent that guy's got, phenomenal.
The first stop is the Bond University Institute of Health and Sport. It's here our scientists will be conducting the laboratory tests.
I'm Mike Klimstein, Associate Professor in Exercise and Sports Science here at Bond University. I'll be overseeing the laboratory tests that we'll be conducting today on the athletes.
It's an easy start for the boys, having their total body fat measured in a state-of-the-art machine, the Bod Pod.
The Bod Pod is actually called air plethysmography. And it's a non-invasive test to estimate how much body fat they have.
Average fat mass for men is between 10 and 22%, 22 to 32 for women. But athletes are generally on the lean side of readings.
The Bod Pod, yeah, that was actually really new for me.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet you.
I'm through, it's my first one behind you.
I was first up and got to put on the silly cap first.
Fantastic.
Didn't really know what to expect.
Try not to move.
Actually having to get inside this thing that like basically reads you from inside out, it's a bit weird.
Perfect.
All good?
All done.
All done.
I was lean, so I was pretty stoked with that, considering the amount of ice cream I ate.
It's 9%.
For elite athletes?
Too much, a bit too much.
All right, here you go.
It's always been a challenge to make sure I've got the right amount of muscle and weight for my position. In the off-season at the moment, I've probably dropped a bit of weight and probably dropped a bit of fat and overall a little bit skinnier than what I am when I play.
Is that what you expected?
Probably not that low. We're normally around 7 or 8, I thought. 6 or 7, I guess.
Yeah, well, that's quite very low.
Yeah, I don't normally put on weight in the off-season. I drop weight, if anything.
Watch out.
Here we go, eh? Ready to go.
All right, here we go.
The boys are tested one after another. The results are as expected, except for one.
We're good.
Give me that one.
Thank you.
Had a look. I was actually quite shocked, to tell you the truth. I just thought it was a little bit high.
Oh,
there was a mistake.
So you're still in the lean area?
Yeah.
You know, I got a really good dietitian and weights coach, and if he knew I was 16, he'd probably lose it, so I'm really sorry.
Kai may be surprised with his reading of 16.3%, but on deeper analysis, it's not unusual. Kai's specialty is open water swimming, in which buoyancy can be improved by greater fat mass. At the other end of the scale, Kurt is extremely lean at 5.6%. All others are lean and well within the range of elite athletes. After the break, the pain begins, and later, the fine art of balance.
Keep paddling, keep paddling. He's gone.
Welcome back to the Bond University Institute of Health and Sport. The athletes have had an easy start, but now it's time for the hard yards.
This is the test, the first lab test, VO2 max test.
I hadn't done the VO2 test before.
The VO2 max test is to determine someone's individual ability to utilize oxygen, and we measure that through the collection of expired gases.
Put simply, the VO2 max is the maximum amount of oxygen a person can use during exercise. Endurance athletes generally do well in this test. The higher the reading, the better. In this gut wrencher, the person who lasts the longest isn't necessarily the best performer. That will be determined by the statistics.
You got 10 minutes from roughly now, you're gonna start.
I always get a bit nervous when I come around other sports stars, and certainly these guys, they're probably some of the fittest guys I've met.
Let's see what Tannen and Kurt are made of. It's youth versus experience.
Welcome to our ex-phys lab. We're gonna collect expired gases, push it to your limit.
I thought, geez, I'm up against Kurt Gidley, and he's got 10 years on me, so, you know, I've got to try and show him up a little bit.
The pressure is on you, Tannen.
I've got my own standards where I know where I've got to get to, and I don't want to disappoint myself.
They'll start running at 15 kilometres an hour after the warm-up, and then every minute we'll increase the grade by 1% until volitional exhaustion.
When there's an IronMan next to you on the next treadmill, well, you just got to do your best.
Okay, boys, you ready to get going? I'll give you a bit of a warm-up. When we start the test is when it goes to 1%. Okay, so a little bit faster. Okay, a bit more of a run, okay?
They soon reach an optimal speed of 15 kilometers an hour, but the incline keeps going up.
Basically, I was just trying to focus on, are your strides long enough, or are they too long, or are they too short?
All right, we're going up again, 4% now. 15 seconds, we're going up. As that treadmill keeps getting steeper and steeper, eventually they'll reach a point where they're unable to complete the test. Looks good.
Kurt's in the, at about 190, 193 beats per minute heart rate, and really he's not gonna be able to hold that for too much longer. That's like almost at ballistic speed.
You feel fine, but the message isn't getting through to your legs to keep pumping your legs, and you start losing a bit of coordination.
It's a top end that counts. That's where the big numbers come from.
Good job, boys. You're doing really well, boys. Really
come on,
well.
Kurt.
Right, Kurt's out.
Yeah, Kurt, well done.
average individual, 20, 25 years of age, is probably about 30 to 35 mils per kg per minute.
So you actually cracked just over 70 mils per kg per minute. That's huge. That's excellent, actually.
You can get to that point where you go, nah, I'm gonna quit, and then you tell yourself, nah, just go that little bit extra.
You look easy.
I was at a point where I just sort of started to blank out a little bit, and then I was trying to say, all right, let's stop. It really pushed me to the brink.
Despite pulling out first, Kurt records the highest reading, 73.3 millilitres per kilogram per minute. Tannen also sets a high mark. These are exceptional results.
All right, mate, well, you're past that one. Hold on. Good stuff. Just well done.
Next up, Kendrick and Lewis.
The VO2 max, I've never done it before. I've always wanted to do it to see how far I can push myself until I actually can't physically go any further.
We have some masks at the club for oxygen and stuff, but I've never worn one because when I run, I always spit to get all the slob out so I can breathe properly.
You know, just being around something like that, it makes you want to be better. Automatically, I wanted to go longer than what he did.
7% of 15Ks, well done.
But as we know, it's not all about lasting the longest. It is about how much oxygen the body can use. Lewis, who's more used to short, sharp bursts in AFL, reaches his limit, but his results may still be strong.
I didn't want to get off the treadmill. It was just, that's all I had.
Kendrick keeps working hard. How this translates into raw data remains to be seen.
That's intense.
You did a good job, good stuff.
Kendrick records just over 46, a considerable way behind Lewis's 64. In explaining this difference, there is one significant factor.
Kendrick's VO2 max of 46.1 mils per kg per minute is probably attributable to him being unaccustomed to running on a treadmill that fast and also that steep of grade.
Next, it's Simon and Kai's turn.
Very nervous.
Bit of a shock to the system when I realised that my hairy chest had to go.
It's going to look bad no matter what.
Yeah, a bit of humour for the boys.
He's had a bit of a shave.
I was looking a little bit like Austin Powers.
Remember, it's the top end of the test that's most important to pull the big number, so you just have to push yourself.
As far as running up hills, I'm not fantastic with them. I'm expecting the other boys to smash me on that one.
Felt reasonable on the VO2 max test.
Airing along.
Good job, Caddy. Stay with it, mate.
I actually felt really good, even probably 20 seconds before I had to pull out, but it just caught me really quickly at the end.
Good job. Well done.
Come on, keep running, Kai. Looks great.
Just tried to shorten my stride and try to stay relaxed as best as I could.
15Ks an hour at 9%. Excellent.
What the VO2 doesn't show in stats is willpower. Kai Hurst has built his career on it.
Yeah, good job.
No.
That's right. Good leg drops down. Take that off.
There's been so many moments in my career that pushed my body to limits where I didn't think, you know, were achievable. But then again, I do that in training. You do your hard yards behind closed doors.
Well done.
And that's what makes champions.
You know, he's a supreme athlete, so it didn't surprise me how well he did.
That was tough. That was tough, though.
It may have been 4 years since Simon last played a test match, but his VO2 of 53 says he's still in good shape.
I would come downstairs. We didn't even make it to the car. And Simon's spewing his guts up, I think. Boy's a little sick.
The test certainly got me. Unfortunately, I had to visit the bathroom.
No dodgy courage to blame, just lack of fitness.
feels better.
Yeah, I feel better.
Overall, interesting results. Again, Kurt Gidley has the most impressive result. Is he on the way to becoming the most likely to make a successful transition to the sport of Ironman? Up next, strength and power.
Drive.
It's a grueling road ahead.
Pain.
This is the Bond University Institute of Health and Sport, a house of pain for our six guinea pigs.
So we're now going to do the bench press test, test of upper body strength and muscle endurance. So you ready to go, Kai?
Yeah, I'll see how we go.
Let's get in and push some weight.
The last time I had done a bench test like that, I just got so dusted. It was embarrassing.
We looked at the bench press as a test of upper body strength and power. We selected a load of 80% of their body weight to normalise for the difference in weight, push as hard as possible and reach that point of maximum physical exertion.
The measurement is simple, the number of repetitions.
Come on, Kai.
They'll primarily be utilising their chest, shoulders and tricep. Muscular fatigue will set in as they're doing more and more reps.
Yeah, I was particularly nervous about the bench just because it's not something I've done in the gym for a very long time.
Come on, Ernie, come on! Oh! Oh, yeah!
Nice work,
Kai. I certainly didn't think I was going to get that considering my max output isn't much higher than that.
That's a good time.
Good job.
Three.
Come on. Get up.
Good job,
mate.
Unreal job.
I tried my best. I just couldn't keep lifting, unfortunately.
Look tough, huh?
Good work.
Didn't surprise me, I struggled. It was good to see where I was at.
Three repetitions for Simon, and Kai sets an early mark for others to chase, 9. Kendrick and Lewis are next.
He looked at his muscles, he looked not too bad, you know, he's pretty big. I'm like, mate, these are all show, like, I've got nothing when it comes to this.
Touch your chest.
Do the first one, and I'm like, man, this is gonna hurt.
Mate, come on.
Push. Can't, Kenny. Come on.
Let's go,
push.
Brother.
Get up. Come on.
Yes.
Nice. For me, that was, I guess it's a PB. I've never done it before, so. I love doing my bench press. You know, I do it maybe twice or three times a week during the season.
Good job.
I was looking at this going, are you kidding? Like, this guy, I was just looking around in disbelief.
12. 13. Good job.
Hips down.
14.
Pain started to kick in. I started losing count. I was really hurting then.
15. Come on, stay with it. 16. Good job, mate. You got one more in you. Come on. Up.
Good job.
Nice work.
It just shows how amazing the, you know, different athletes are at different things.
Lewis Jetta, not only fast, but very, very strong. 16 repetitions.
In the bench press challenge, I thought I'm going to get annihilated in this one.
I'm jamming up, push. That's it, come on. Let's go.
I was stoked to just get above 10.
Push.
Probably
don't do too much weights, mate, do you?
No, not at all. Yeah. Not at all, really.
Yeah, so he's done well there.
Kurt Gidley was just, he was just insane. He bashed out the first 10.
Yeah. 11. 12.
Seven, eight, I think it was.
Phenomenal efforts from both Tannen and Kurt. The young gun with 14 reps. And the not-so-young gun pumps out the top score for all of the boys, 17. The results reflect the strength needed for the footy coach.
So the Ironman might not be as strong as the football athletes in this test because their sport is more an endurance event. The Ironman were relatively similar. Tannen actually was leading the group there, which was a really good result for him. And Simon found the test a little bit more challenging.
Now from strength to power.
So we saved the most difficult test for last, and that was the repeat sprint test.
This is James. He's going to take you through your paces.
All right, Kendrick, it's 6 10-second sprints at maximal effort with 20 seconds break in between each run. And the purpose of that test is to basically look at how powerful are the athletes.
It measures their power output. We look at it relative to their body weight.
You ready? All right. 3, 2, 1. Go, 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 go.
Push, push, come on.
Come on.
5 seconds. Go, go,
drive,
go, go,
drive,
go,
drive, go. Drive, 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 drive. Come on, come on, come on, come push on. It. 3, 2, 1. Job.
Having the anaerobic sprint test last, I guess, was that was tough because that was by far the hardest one.
3, 2, 1. Go, 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 go.
Come on, come on, come on.
Push, push, push.
Lift it up.
Come on. Drive.
Jetta,
he was able
to maintain his power output throughout those 6 tests, so he had less fatigue.
Drive.
I figured I'd just go hard and try hold on.
And whee!
I just feel the pain, lactic acid built in.
The pain.
3, 2, 1.
Set go, and I went for it.
Push. Come on.
Got to like 8 seconds, and I was like, oh God, I'm gonna fall off his bike. It's like you're paddling in slow motion. It's just weird.
He did really well. Probably had the highest peak power output.
You only have 20 seconds between each effort. You can't shake your legs out or anything like that, and that's where all the lactic acid is. It's just all in your legs, it's all built up.
Right now, their legs will be burning. They'll have difficulty continuing on with the test.
Keep going.
My quads were going probably before I started the test.
5 seconds. Drive. Done and stop. 3, 2, 1, stop. Good job.
Tannen and Kurt rank first and second. Their highest wattage is very similar. So is Kendrick and Lewis's. What is interesting is the Ironman maintained more consistent power through all 6 sprints than the other athletes. Just ahead, the do's and don'ts of staying afloat. This is the Nutri-Grain Sports Star Challenge. Ironman, Kai Hurst, Kendrick Louis, Tannen Linden, and elite sports stars Kurt Gidley, Simon Kadich, and Lewis Jetta have been put through their paces at the lab at Bond University Institute of Health and Sport. But Ironman racing is not all about fitness. You may have the best VO2 max or be able to lift a truckload of weight, but it doesn't mean you're the best. Currumbin Beach. Here the athletes will be taught some basic Ironman skills by their mentors before undergoing some specific challenges designed by Ironman great Zane Holmes. First, how to wade, porpoise and swim.
I was looking forward to today, getting to the beach and away from that lab, and also learning off the Nutri-Grain boys. They've got plenty to teach us in those areas.
So for us, wading, it's pretty important because we, you know, we go off the start line, everyone bang, and it's sort of like a shallow bank like this. It's really important to sort of get towards the front.
When a sport is about racing, every single second counts. So things that mightn't look that important are suddenly critical. And that's how it is with wading.
Look at that, he's a natural. Gets his knees up nice and high and he's just really light on his feet, so he just clears the water really easy. So he nailed it first go. I think he did it better than I did. Nailed it!
Lewis proves he's a speed machine. The long legs that help him cover the ground quickly in AFL help him to stay on top of it in the water. Genetics might give Lewis the edge here, but Kurt and Simon look comfortable too.
And then basically when we get into a little bit deeper water, you want it to sort of porpoise. So like taking a dive and taking a breath and taking a dive.
And you reckon stay under the water longer or keep it quick?
Yeah, if you can grab the bottom, like crawl on the bottom a bit.
The porpoising changes everything in a heartbeat. It's not only about what you do under the water, but how you handle your breathing. Being caught short of breath can add crucial seconds to your time. Then there's the pressure of putting it all together in a race situation.
So, guys, you've just been taken through some of the skills of wading by your Ironman mentors. Lewis, you picked it up instantly, mate.
It's not too bad. I've got long legs, so hopefully it works in my favour.
I've seen Lewis in his warm-ups and, man, he's got the big, long, string-bean legs and it looked like he was running on top of the water at one stage, so I knew he was up against some competition.
We're going to incorporate those skills now into a race. So you'll be starting here, using the wading skills and dolphin diving out around the Nutri-Grain cam and back in, finishing through the Nutri-Grain flags.
Two laps over a small course. These guys are used to playing in front of massive crowds. Not much chance of a rev up this time.
On your marks, set.
That's waiting to a T.
Me and Simon were going the right way, I think clockwise, and...
Oh, he's gonna go around the wrong way.
Lewis was doing his own thing, going anti-clockwise.
Yeah, I think I kicked Simon. Don't want an old guy beat me.
It was a good battle.
Hey, Lewis!
We thought it would be easy in our minds because it wasn't a long distance, but coming back for the second lap, I couldn't believe how heavy our legs were.
Kurt?
Oh, that's solid.
Is that a bit harder than you expected?
Way harder than I expected. It's not that far out, but blows your legs so quick.
Yeah, I tried to just bump into him and slow him down.
Slow him down.
At one point, I think I doggy paddled around the... It's hard. It blew me out.
The mix of speed and endurance needed in the NRL serves Kurt well. Win or lose, it's not as easy as it looks. And that's one of the beauties of sport. Give Simon Kadich a bat and he's in his comfort zone. But give Kai the bat. So let's flip the roles again. Give Kai and the other men skis and paddles. Now for Simon, Kurt and Lewis. It can't be that hard, can it?
Good old ski. The hardest leg of all.
Is it?
Yeah, probably. Close to it.
All right. I'm a bit of a waterman myself, like trying to go for a surf.
I think Kurt said he sat on it maybe once, you know, many years ago. All right,
ready?
Yeah. Whoa. Oh.
Yeah,
that's
good. Gonna
be a long day.
I think he left me from my own device there.
It's a lot harder than I thought. You get it.
Yeah, and that one's pivots.
When you look at Simon, he's very fit, he's very active, he's got great core stability. He knows how to swing a bat, and I thought he'd be able to swing a paddle.
Keep paddling, keep paddling. Concentrate on the front.
He's gone.
It wasn't the case.
When we were playing cricket, normally if there's a drop of rain, we're straight in the sheds. The boys make it look so easy, so you sort of look at this ski and think, oh, it should be fine to sit up, but it's so light, it's so easy to flip.
Lewis just sat on it, he goes, yeah, give me the paddle, I want to chuck both legs in. You know, he was just wanted to learn so quick.
Oh, yeah!
There we go.
Mate, he was shocking.
They're a hard weapon to master. It takes a very long time. You know, I've been paddling since I was 13 years old.
It's all well and good trying to stay upright on flat water, but the reality is the Ironmen have to perform in much tougher, dangerous conditions.
In the ocean, it's a different sort of ball game. You know, you're going out over waves and all different elements sort of pushing you off, and wind and all that sort of stuff you got to allow for.
It's about strength, balance, reading the conditions, and don't forget guts. This can be a rodeo, surf style. Now back to the flatwater cowboys. If you fall off your horse, you just have to get back on. Again and again and again. The boys finally get it. Well, they reckon they've got it good enough to have a crack at a race.
We got the competition ski. I thought I'd try and take it as slow and easy as possible.
Okay, on the line, here we go.
Record, Kurt won. It's 2 from 2 for the Newcastle Knight star. So far, he looks the most suited to becoming an Ironman. But as they say in footy, you're only as good as your last game. Coming up, trouble time for one of our elites. Although the sport of Ironman is about skill and fitness, it's also about being a waterman, knowing how to read conditions and making the best of them. Paddleboarding is a great example. When you've got your L plates on, it helps to learn in gentle conditions. But right now, Kurt, Lewis, and Simon don't have that luxury.
As you can see, the conditions here are pretty tough. It's windy, it's choppy, and it's going to make it really difficult. But this is where the Ironmen really excel in these conditions with their skills.
To be put into a shore break, it's one of the nastiest things you could probably do to someone who has never paddled a board before in the surf.
So, guys, we're going to try and master catching a wave on a board.
Yep, that's exactly where your chest needs to be.
We took the board out for a bit of a spin. He'd never been on a board either before.
Boom! And there we go. Heads. Perfect. Yep. Straight through. Yes. You got this?
Thanks, mate.
I ran through some simple tips here and there, and he went straight out. Turned around, grabbed the shorey, and rode it in.
This is a bit like ducking your head into a Brett Lee bouncer.
Straight over the front handlebars. Straight over the GoPro, and I thought, oh, this is going to be a disaster.
I said to Lewis, I said, mate, you don't want to be doing that. You'd be going straight into the sand.
luckily the board survived and so did I, so that was a bit of humour for the boys.
You know, he just dusted himself off, got back up and said, I want to do it again. He, you know, the guys just definitely got to you.
Forget Simon, it's all eyes on the board. All okay. Now to Lewis and his lanky legs.
No, just running in with a floaty kayak thing, whatever it was called, is hard enough, let alone trying to, you know, surf it back.
It can be a real challenge being out of your comfort zone, but it can reveal the mental side of an athlete. In the case of Lewis, it's never give up.
For someone like Lewis, who hasn't caught waves on a board in his life, that's hard. He had a face full of sand, he'd eaten most of it.
Kurt Gidley benefits from some inside knowledge. He's paddled on clubby boards before. The fatigue shows the very specific demands of IronMan. While Lewis had performed well under lab conditions when it came to the bench press, the board requires the use of very different muscles. The board can be excruciating. The longest distances in an Ironman race can be 1,500 metres. Then you have other events like the infamous Molokai, 52 Ks.
Well, Lewis was out the back. He's like, oh, how you feeling, mate? He goes, my arms are killing me. Like. And I know exactly how he feels, especially during a race. And you just want to lay down and stretch your arms, especially in the wind. But you can't stop, because as soon as you stop in the wind, it's just going to blow you backwards.
Trying to pick the right wave and sliding back, and all the little things all the Ironman guys do and women, they do, is make it look so easy.
And so does Kurt. The Newcastle boy looks right at home.
He's just a phenomenal athlete. He's just so strong, and he was so determined to, you know, make sure that he got out the back first, he got the wave in.
So from Newcastle, New South Wales and Australian rugby league star to would-be, could-be, maybe he will be an Ironman, Kurt Gidley has dominated his mates from rival sports. Stay with us after the break. Anyone heard of beeping mad?
Level 4, 9.
No matter what you do in the water, sometimes Ironman comes down to what happens here, running. When on sand, it adds a whole new dimension. One way to test this in the Ironman is a favourite of many a fitness trainer.
Okay, guys, welcome to the beep test. This is obviously going to be a lot more difficult than your standard beep test because you're in really soft sand. We want to see you push yourselves to the absolute limit. Here we go.
Start level 1-1.
The beep test is an endurance test. Athletes need to run back and forth over a 20-metre course, keeping pace with recorded beeps that get quicker about every minute. Each new stage or level is tougher than the last.
Level 1-4.
You know, it's always a daunting one to come up against, whether you're unfit at the time or whether you're one of the fittest guys in the club. I think everyone knows where they probably should get to and where their standards are, and I've got anywhere between, you know, 14 or 15.
If Kurt achieves that level today, it's likely he will be up with the Ironmen, if not ahead of them.
I've done beep tests throughout the years of cricket. A lot of the time did them outdoors on grass. You tend to fatigue a bit quicker because you probably don't grip as well.
What makes this challenge even harder is running in sand, which requires a technique that Kurt, Simon and Lewis know nothing about.
In the sand, it was a different ball game.
I noticed the boys use their toes a fair bit. They seem like they glide across it pretty easy. We probably look a little bit heavy-footed at times when we're running on sand.
They're used to running on a flat, you know, pretty even surface and with boots on, so don't have to worry about grip. Soft sand, barefoot, it's pretty tough, so you do have to dig your toes in and push off sort of the balls of your feet to get that bit of acceleration.
Once you dig in, you gotta, I think it's a lot of effort just trying to turn around and get back out again.
Lewis Jetta, known for his speed in the AFL, shows just how unique the sport of Ironman is. Sure, Lewis can run fast on grass, but sand is a great leveller.
Miss that, Lewis. That's it, mate.
I learned a lot just doing beep tests on the sand and how much it hurts and how fun you can make it. I don't know if other people would say that, but I found it a little bit fun.
Lewis surrenders just before stage 9.
It's a lot different. My quad started blowing up really early. I think on level 2. But I've never done it before, and it's amazing. It's hard.
Cricketer Simon Kadich is used to running between wickets, but like his mates here, digging your toes in is very different to digging in for long innings.
The beauty of our game in cricket is that it's obviously a skill-based sport and it's not reliant on, I guess, the same physical attributes that the Ironman need, so we're lucky in a way because it's not as tough.
Simon lasts only 2 laps longer than Lewis. The beep test is an exhausting way to finish all the challenges the guys have had to do. Overall, Kurt has been the best performer, a great example of how fit NRL players need to be. Yet, is it enough to be an Ironman?
I do think part of my game is that I am a fit player, but I'm fit because I like to try and keep the rest of my team motivated and try and lead by example.
But in the sand, it's the Ironmen who do exactly that, as Kurt pulls out. He reaches 86 laps, a few levels less than his usual on a grass field.
Any challenge to put in front of the sportsman, I can almost guarantee that they're going to give it their all and, you know, have an absolute solid crack at it. And, you know, Kurt definitely did that today.
Level 12, 1.
Not surprisingly, this challenge comes down to the Ironmen. Kai, first to falter, but Tannen and Kendrick remain strong. Kendrick much more at home here than on the treadmill. This test, a great example of sports-specific skills.
It's amazing how much more you can get out of yourself after that you first initially think, nah, I'm going to have to stop.
They are now running at 14.5 kilometres an hour. Even on flat, solid ground, that is good going, and just a touch slower than they reached in the VO2 test. Tannen powers on, but Kendrick has had enough.
Started to cramp up in my right glute, so I thought I had to pull up, and pulled up a bit sore, actually.
And 2 laps later, Tannen says no more after level 13.5. His legs are burning, just like Ironmen feel when they are racing. All 3 Ironmen have performed well, an indication of their knowledge of the conditions and their fitness. The difference between the Ironmen and the elites is significant. 50 laps from Tannen at the top to Lewis at the bottom. The maximum distance reached, nearly 2.4 kilometres.
Based on the test results that we've seen, Kurt has all the physical attributes to become an elite Ironman.
But of course, he needs the skills too. Keep working on them, Kurt. You never know where you just might end up. Next week, 3 more athletes, 3 more Ironmen. Who will be the best?
His aerobic fitness is definitely the highest we've ever tested.
Then, a race between everyone, a matter of pride, as competitive instincts kick in. First and second, their highest wattage is very similar. So is Kendrick and Lewis's. What is interesting is the Ironmen maintained more consistent power through all 6 sprints than the other athletes. Just ahead, the do's and don'ts of staying afloat. This is the Nutri-Grain Sports Star Challenge. IronMan, Kai Hurst, Kendrick Louie, Tannen Linden, and elite sports stars Kurt Gidley, Simon Kadich, and Lewis Jetta have been put through their paces at the lab at Bond University Institute of Health and Sport. But Ironman racing is not all about fitness. You may have the best VO2 max or be able to lift a truckload of weight, but it doesn't mean you're the best. Currumbin Beach. Here the athletes will be taught some basic Ironman skills by their mentors before undergoing some specific challenges designed by Ironman great Zane Holmes. First, how to wade, porpoise and swim.
I was looking forward to today, getting to the beach and away from that lab, and also learning off the Nutri-Grain boys. They've got plenty to teach us in those areas.
So for us, wading, it's pretty important because we, you know, we go off the start line, everyone bang, and it's sort of like a shallow bank like this. It's really important to sort of get towards the front.
When a sport is about racing, every single second counts. So things that mightn't look that important are suddenly critical. And that's how it is with wading.
Look at that, he's a natural. Gets his knees up nice and high and he's just really light on his feet, so he just clears the water really easy. So he nailed it first go. I think he did it better than I did. Nailed it!
Lewis proves he's a speed machine. The long legs that help him cover the ground quickly in AFL help him to stay on top of it in the water. Genetics might give Lewis the edge here, but Kurt and Simon look comfortable too.
And then basically when we get into a little bit deeper water, you want to sort of porpoise. So like taking a dive and then taking a breath and taking a dive.
And you reckon stay under the water longer or keep it quick?
Yeah, if you can grab the bottom, like crawl along the bottom a bit.
The porpoising changes everything in a heartbeat. It's not only about what you do under the water, but how you handle your breathing. Being caught short of breath can add crucial seconds to your time. Then there's the pressure of putting it all together in a race situation.
So, guys, you've just been taken through some of the skills of wading by your Ironman mentors. Lewis, you picked it up instantly, mate.
Oh, it's not too bad. I've got long legs, so hopefully it works in my favour.
I've seen Lewis in his warm-ups, and man, he's got the big, long, string-bearing legs, and it looked like he was running on top of the water at one stage, so I knew he was up against some competition.
We're going to incorporate those skills now into a race. So you'll be starting here using the wading skills and dolphin diving out around the Nutri-Grain cam and back in, finishing through the Nutri-Grain flags.
Two laps over a small course. These guys are used to playing in front of massive crowds. Not much chance of a rev up this time.
On your marks, set.
Waiting to a T.
Me and Simon were going the right way, I think, clockwise, and...
Oh, he's going to go around the wrong way.
Lewis was doing his own thing, going anti-clockwise.
Yeah, I think I kicked Simon. Don't want an old guy beating me.
It was a good battle.
Hey, Lewis!
We thought it would be easy in our minds because it wasn't a long distance, but coming back for the second lap, I couldn't believe how heavy our legs were.
Kurt.
Oh, that's solid.
Is that a bit harder than you expected?
Way harder than I expected. It's not that far out, but it blows your legs so quick.
Yeah. I tried to just bump into him, slow him down. At one point, I think I doggy paddled around the... It's hard. It blew me out.
The mix of speed and endurance needed in the NRL serves Kurt well. Win or lose, it's not as easy as it looks. And that's one of the beauties of sport. Give Simon Kadich a bat and he's in his comfort zone. But give Kai the bat.
Oh! Oh,
So let's flip the roles again. Give Kai and the other men skis and paddles. Now for Simon, Kurt and Lewis. It can't be that hard, can it?
Good old ski.
Hardest, yeah, probably
the hardest leg of all.
Is it?
Yeah, probably. Close to it. All right.
I'm a bit of a waterman myself, like trying to go for a surf.
I think Kurt said he sat on it maybe once, you know, many years ago.
All right, ready? Yeah. It's gonna be a long day.
I think he left me from my own device there.
It's a lot harder than I thought. You get it.
Yeah, and that one's pivots.
When you look at Simon, he's very fit, he's very active, he's got great core stability. He knows how to swing a bat, and I thought he'd be able to swing a paddle.
Keep paddling. Concentrate on the front.
He's gone.
It wasn't the case.
When we were playing cricket, normally if there's a drop of rain, we're straight in the sheds.
The boys make it look so easy, so you sort of look at this ski and think, oh, it should be fine to sit up, but it's so light, it's so easy to flip.
Lewis just sat on it, he goes, yeah, give me the paddle, I want to chuck both legs in. You know, he was just wanted to learn so quick.
Oh, yeah!
Here
we go. Okay. Oh, no.
Mate, he was shocking.
They're a hard weapon to master. It takes a very long time. You know, I've been paddling since I was 13 years old.
It's all well and good trying to stay upright on flat water, but the reality is the Ironmen have to perform in much tougher, dangerous conditions.
In the ocean, it's a different sort of ball game. You know, you're going out over waves and all different elements sort of pushing you off, and wind and all that sort of stuff you got to allow for.
It's about strength, balance, reading the conditions, and don't forget guts. This can be a rodeo. Surf style. Now back to the flatwater cowboys. If you fall off your horse, you just have to get back on. Again and again and again. The boys finally. Ironman is one of the most grueling sports in the world. Being fit is a given. But what does it really take to rise to the sport's elite level? We are taking six of Australia's very best from other sports and pitting them against our greatest Ironmen. In the name of science, we will push them to and beyond their limits. Gut-wrenching tests in both the laboratory and on the beach. Then the finale, a race to determine who just might make it as an Ironman. This is the Nutri-Grain Sports Star Challenge. Here we are at one of Australia's favourite tourist destinations. These are 12 of our favourite athletes. What awaits them is the unknown.
I always thought the Ironman was very demanding and something that I would never try my hand at.
Welcome to the sunny Gold Coast, the perfect place to put your feet up and relax. But for you six elite sports people, there'll be no relaxing this week. We're going to team up three elite sports people with three Ironmen each week.
I was pretty excited. You know, any chance to challenge myself in someone else's sport is a great challenge.
By the end of these 2 weeks, we'll work out who is best suited to be an Ironman. It's going to be quite a couple of weeks.
When I got the call, I said yes straight away. It's going to be good fun.
We will be taking you to the lab to be tested at Bond University. We will be pushing you guys to your limit and beyond.
You challenge yourself against athletes from other codes and other sports. It's really good.
You guys might be able to throw or kick a ball, but I think you're going to be in for a real shock. I'm going to be at the beach taking you through the Ironman skills.
I think it's really awesome to see some of our best Australian athletes in all different kinds of sports coming together and giving it a go.
Let's start off. Simon Kadich down here, former Australian opening batsman. You are with a multi Nutri-Grain winner. Kai Hurst, dual Olympian and four-time Australian Ironman champion.
I'm Simon Kadich, former Australian Test cricketer.
Simon played 56 test matches, highest score 157.
Every sport has an element of mental toughness. It's about being able to perform under pressure when the pressure's on.
I was eyeing him off, I was going, oh, he's about my age, maybe a little bit older, so we're the veterans of the whole group. He's a legend.
Kurt Gidley, you are going to be teamed up with Tannen Linden. 22-year-old Tannen Linden is a former Australian junior Ironman champion.
This is a dream come true. I'm still pinching myself. It's crazy.
Kurt Gidley, Newcastle Knights.
Kurt Gidley is 32 and still one of the fittest in the game.
We have to play for 80 minutes, short break at halftime. You've got to be physically fit, strong and mentally tough.
And of course, from the Sydney Swans, Lewis Jetta, Kendrick Louie, the big Manly Sea Eagles supporter. Kendrick Louie, runner-up in the 2012-13 Nutri-Grain Series and another former national junior champion.
Lewis Jetta here, Sydney Swans AFL, and I play with midfield.
Lewis Jetta, renowned for his speed and skill.
When I got read out, I was with Lewis Jetta. I was pretty pumped. He's a great bloke. He's extremely determined. The talent that guy's got, phenomenal.
The first stop is the Bond University Institute of Health and Sport. It's here our scientists will be conducting the laboratory tests.
I'm Mike Klimstein, Associate Professor in Exercise and Sports Science here at Bond University. I'll be overseeing the laboratory tests that we'll be conducting today on the athletes.
It's an easy start for the boys, having their total body fat measured in a state-of-the-art machine, the Bod Pod.
The Bod Pod is actually called air plethysmography. And it's a non-invasive test to estimate how much body fat they have.
Average fat mass for men is between 10 and 22%, 22 to 32 for women. But athletes are generally on the lean side of readings.
The Bod Pod, yeah, that was actually really new for me.
Nice to meet you. Hi, nice to meet you. Come through, just my close door behind you.
I was first up and got to put on the silly cap first.
Fantastic.
Didn't really know what to expect.
Try not to move.
Actually having to get inside this thing that like basically reads you from inside out, it's a bit weird.
All right, you did perfect.
All good.
All done.
I was lean, so I was pretty stoked with that. Considering the amount of ice cream I eat.
It's 9%.
For elite athletes.
Too much.
All right, here we go.
It's always been a challenge to make sure I've got the right amount of muscle and weight for my position. In the off-season at the moment, I've probably dropped a bit of weight and probably dropped a bit of fat and overall a little bit skinnier than what I am when I play.
Is that what you expected?
Probably not that low. We're normally around 7 or 8, I thought, 6 or 7, I guess.
Yeah, well, it's very low.
Yeah, I don't normally put on weight. I drop weight, if anything.
Watch out.
Here we go.
All right, here we go.
The boys are tested one after another. The results are as expected, except for one.
We're good.
Give me that
one.
Thank you.
Had a look.
I was actually quite shocked, to tell you the truth. I just thought it was a little bit high.
Oh,
there was a mistake.
So you're still in the lean area?
Yeah.
You know, I got a really good dietitian and weights coach, and if he knew I was 16, he'd probably lose it, so I'm really sorry.
Kai may be surprised with his reading of 16.3%, but on deeper analysis, it's not unusual. Kai's specialty is open water swimming, in which buoyancy can be improved by greater fat mass. At the other end of the scale, Kurt is extremely lean at 5.6%. All others are lean and well within the range of elite athletes. After the break, the pain begins, and later, the fine art of balance.
Keep paddling. He's gone.
Welcome back to the Bond University Institute of Health and Sport. The athletes have had an easy start, but now it's time for the hard yards.
This is the test, the first lab test, VO2 max test.
I hadn't done the VO2 test before.
The VO2 max test is to determine someone's individual ability to utilize oxygen, and we measure that through the collection of expired gases.
Put simply, the VO2 max is the maximum amount of oxygen a person can use during exercise. Endurance athletes generally do well in this test. The higher the reading, the better. In this gut wrencher, the person who lasts the longest isn't necessarily the best performer. That will be determined by the statistics.
You got 10 minutes from roughly now. You're gonna start.
I always get a bit nervous when I come around other sports stars, and certainly these guys, they're probably some of the fittest guys I've met.
Let's see what Tannen and Kurt are made of. It's youth versus experience.
Welcome to our ex-phys lab. We're going to collect expired gases, push it to your limit.
I thought, geez, I'm up against Kurt Gidley, and he's got 10 years on me, so, you know, I've got to try and show him up a little bit.
The pressure is on you, Tannen.
I've got my own standards where I know where I've got to get to, and I don't want to disappoint myself.
They'll start running at 15 kilometres an hour after the warm-up, and then every minute we'll increase the grade by 1% until volitional exhaustion.
When there's an Ironman next to you on the next treadmill, well, you just got to do your best.
Okay, boys, you ready to get going? I'll give you a bit of a warm-up. When we start the test is when it goes to 1%. Okay, so a little bit faster. Okay, a bit more of a run, okay?
They soon reach an optimal speed of 15 kilometers an hour, but the incline keeps going up.
Basically, I was just trying to focus on, are your strides long enough, or are they too long, or are they too short?
All right, we're going up again, 4% now. 15 seconds, we're going up. As that treadmill keeps getting steeper and steeper, eventually they'll reach a point where they're unable to complete the test. Looks good.
Test in the, at about 190, 193 beats per minute heart rate, and really he's not going to be able to hold that for too much longer. That's like almost at ballistic speed.
You feel fine, but the message isn't getting through to your legs to keep pumping your legs, and you start losing a bit of coordination.
It's a top end that counts. That's where the big numbers come from.
Good job, boys. Doing really well, boys. Really
come on,
well.
Kurt.
Right, Kurt's out. Yeah, Kurt, well done.
Average individual, 20, 25 years of age, is probably about 30 to 35 mils per kg per minute. So you actually cracked just over 70 mils per kg per minute. That's huge.
Is it?
That's excellent, actually.
You can get to that point where you go, nah, I'm gonna quit, and then you tell yourself, nah, just go that little bit extra.
You look easy.
I was at a point where I just sort of started to blank out a little bit, and then I was trying to say, all right, let's stop, let's stop. It really pushed me to the brink.
Despite pulling out first, Kurt records the highest reading, 73.3 millilitres per kilogram per minute. Tannen also sets a high mark. These are exceptional results.
All right, mate, we'll get past that one.
Just,
well done.
Good stuff. Just,
well done.
Next up, Kendrick and Lewis.
The VO2 max, I've never done it before. I've always wanted to do it to see how far I can push myself until I actually can't physically go any further.
We have some masks at the club for oxygen and stuff, but I've never worn one because when I run, I always spit to get all the slob out so I can breathe properly.
You know, just being around something like that, it makes you want to be better. Automatically, I wanted to go longer than what he did.
7% of 15Ks, well done.
But as we know, it's not all about lasting the longest. It is about how much oxygen the body can use. Lewis, who's more used to short, sharp bursts in AFL, reaches his limit, but his results may still be strong.
I didn't want to get off the treadmill. It was just, that's all I had.
Kendrick keeps working hard. How this translates into raw data remains to be seen.
That's intense.
You did a good job, good stuff.
Kendrick records just over 46, a considerable way behind Lewis's 64.
In explaining this difference, there is one significant factor.
Kendrick's VO2 max of 46.1 mils per kg per minute is probably attributable to him being unaccustomed to running on a treadmill that fast and also that steep of grade.
Next, it's Simon and Kai's turn.
Very nervous.
Bit of a shock to the system when I realised that my hairy chest had to go.
It's going to look bad no matter what.
Yeah, a bit of humour for the boys.
He's had a bit of a shave.
I was looking a little bit like Austin Powers.
Remember, it's the top end of the test that's most important to pull the big number, so you just have to push yourself.
As far as running up hills, I'm not fantastic with them. I'm expecting the other boys to smash me on that one.
Felt reasonable on the VO2 max test.
Powering along.
Good job, Katie. Stay with it, mate. Stay with it.
I actually felt really good, even probably 20 seconds before I had to pull out, but it just caught me really quickly at the end.
Good job. Well done.
Come on, big run, Katie. Looks great.
Just tried to shorten my stride and try to just stay relaxed as best as I could.
15 k's an hour at 9%. Excellent.
What the VO2 doesn't show in stats is willpower. Kai Hurst has built his career on it.
Yeah, good job.
Well done, man.
That's right. Good leg drops down. Take that off.
There's been so many moments in my career that pushed my body to limits where I didn't think, you know, were achievable. But then again, I do that in training. You do your hard yards behind closed doors.
Well done.
And that's what makes champions.
You know, he's a supreme athlete, so it didn't surprise me how well he did.
That was tough. That was tough, though.
It may have been 4 years since Simon last played a test match, but his VO2 of 53 says he's still in good shape.
We'd come downstairs. We didn't even make it to the car. And Simon's spewing his guts up, I think. Boy's a little sick.
The test certainly got me. Unfortunately, I had to visit the bathroom.
No dodgy curry to blame, just lack of fitness.
You look better.
Yeah, I feel better.
Overall, interesting results. Again, Kurt Gidley has the most impressive result. Is he on the way to becoming the most likely to make a successful transition to the sport of Ironman? Up next, strength and power.
Drive.
It's a grueling road ahead.
The pain.
This is the Bond University Institute of Health and Sport, a house of pain for our six guinea pigs.
So we're now going to do the bench press test of upper body strength and muscle endurance. So, you ready?
Click out. Well, they reckon they've got it good enough to have a crack at a race.
We got the competition ski. I thought I'd try and take it as slow and easy as possible.
Okay, on the line, here we go.
For the record, Kurt won. It's 2 from 2 for the Newcastle Knights star. So far, he looks the most suited to becoming an Ironman. But as they say in footy, you're only as good as your last game. Coming up, trouble time for one of our elites. Although the sport of Ironman is about skill and fitness, it's also about being a waterman, knowing how to read conditions and making the best of them. Paddleboarding is a great example. When you've got your L plates on, it helps to learn in gentle conditions. But right now, Kurt Lewis and Simon don't have that luxury.
As you can see, the conditions here are pretty tough. It's windy, it's choppy, and it's going to make it really difficult. But this is where the Ironmen really excel in these conditions with their skills.
To be put into a shore break, it's one of the nastiest things you could probably do to someone who has never paddled a board before in the surf.
So, guys, we're going to try and master catching a wave on a board.
Yep, that's exactly where your chest needs to be.
We took the board out for a bit of a spin. He'd never been on a board either before.
Boom! Yeah. There we go. It's perfect. Yep. Straight through. Yes. You got this?
Thanks, mate. I ran through some simple tips here and there, and he went straight out. Turned around, grabbed the shorey, and rode it in.
This is a bit like ducking your head into a Brett Lee bouncer.
Straight over the front handlebars. Straight over the GoPro, and I thought, oh, this is going to be a disaster.
I said to Lewis, I said, mate, you don't want to be doing that. You'd be going straight into the sand.
Luckily, the board survived and so did I, so that was a bit of humour for the boys.
You know, he just dusted himself off, got back up and said, I want to do it again. The guys just definitely got to.
Forget Simon, it's all eyes on the board. All okay. Now to Lewis and his lanky legs.
No, just running in with a floaty kayak thing, whatever it was called, is hard enough, let alone trying to, surf it back.
It can be a real challenge being out of your comfort zone, but it can reveal the mental side of an athlete. In the case of Lewis, it's never give up.
For someone like Lewis, who hasn't caught waves on a board in his life, that's hard. He had a face full of sand. He'd eaten most of it.
Kurt Gidley benefits from some inside knowledge. He's paddled on clubby boards before. The fatigue shows the very specific demands of Ironman. While Lewis had performed well under lab conditions when it came to the bench press, the board requires the use of very different muscles. The board can be excruciating. The longest distances in an Ironman race can be 1,500 metres. Then you have other events like the infamous Molokai, 52 Ks.
Well, Lewis was out the back. He's like, oh, how are you feeling, mate? He goes, my arms are killing me. And I know exactly how he feels, especially during a race, and you just want to lay down and stretch your arms, especially in the wind, but you can't stop, because as soon as you stop in the wind, it's just going to blow you backwards.
Trying to pick the right wave and sliding back, and all the little things all the Ironman guys do and women, they do, is make it look so easy.
And so does Kurt. The Newcastle boy looks right at home.
He's just a phenomenal athlete. He's just so strong, and he was so determined to, make sure that he got out the back first, he got the wave in.
So from Newcastle, New South Wales, and Australian rugby league star, to would-be, could-be, maybe he will be an Ironman, Kurt Gidley has dominated his mates from rival sports. Stay with us after the break. Anyone heard of beeping mad?
Level 4, 9.
No matter what you do in the water, sometimes Ironman comes down to what happens here, running. When on sand, it adds a whole new dimension. One way to test this in the Ironman is a favourite of many a fitness trainer.
Okay, guys, welcome to the beep test. This is obviously going to be a lot more difficult than your standard beep test because you're in really soft sand. We want to see you push yourselves to the absolute limit. Here we go.
Start level 1, 1.
The beep test is an endurance test. Athletes need to run back and forth over a 20-metre course, keeping pace with recorded beeps that get quicker about every minute. Each new stage or level is tougher than the last.
You know, it's always a daunting one to come up against, whether you're unfit at the time or whether you're one of the fittest guys in the club. I think everyone knows where they probably should get to and where their standards are, and I've got anywhere between 14 or 15.
If Kurt achieves that level today, it's likely he will be up with the Ironmen, if not ahead of them.
I've done beep tests throughout the years of cricket. A lot of the time did them outdoors on grass. You tend to fatigue a bit quicker because you probably don't grip as well.
What makes this challenge even harder is running in sand, which requires a technique that Kurt, Simon and Lewis know nothing about.
In the sand, it was a different ball game.
I noticed the boys use their toes a fair bit. They seem like they glide across it pretty easy. We probably look a little bit heavy-footed at times when we're running on sand.
They're used to running on a flat, you know, pretty even surface and with boots on, so don't have to worry about grip. Soft sand, barefoot, it's pretty tough, so you do have to dig your toes in and push off sort of the balls of your feet to get that bit of acceleration.
Once you dig in, you got to...
There you go, Kai.
Yeah,
all right,
see how we go.
Let's get in and push some weight.
The last time I had done a bench test like that, I just got so dusted, it was embarrassing.
We looked at the bench press as a test of upper body strength and power. We selected a load of 80% of their body weight to normalise for the difference in weight, push as hard as possible and reach that point of maximum physical exertion.
The measurement is simple, the number of repetitions.
Come on, Kai.
They'll primarily be utilising their chest, shoulders and tricep. Muscular fatigue will set in as they're doing more and more reps.
Yeah, I was particularly nervous about the bench just because it's not something I've done in the gym for a very long time.
Come on, Ernie, come on! Ah! Oh, yeah!
Nice work,
Kai. I certainly didn't think I was going to get that considering my max output isn't much higher than that.
It's going well, mate.
Yeah.
Two.
That's three, four. Yeah, roll the double.
Four.
Good job. Three.
Come on.
Get up.
Come on. Good job, mate. Unreal job.
I tried my best. I just couldn't keep lifting, unfortunately.
Good tough, huh?
Good work.
It didn't surprise me, I struggled. It was good to see where I was at.
Three repetitions for Simon, and Kai sets an early mark for others to chase, 9. Kendrick and Lewis are next.
He looked at his muscles, he looked not too bad, you know, he's pretty big.
I'm like, mate, these are all show, like, I've got nothing when it comes to this.
Touch your chest.
Did the first one, and I'm like, man, this is gonna hurt.
Mate, come on. Push.
Can't, Kenny. Come on,
let's go,
push.
Brother.
Get up. Come on.
Yes.
Nice. Good job. For me, that was, you know, I guess it's a PB. I've never done it before, so.
I love doing my bench press. You know, I do it maybe twice or three times a week during the season.
Good job.
11. I was looking at this going, are you kidding? Like, this guy, I was just looking around in disbelief.
12. 13. Good job.
Hips down.
14.
Pain started to kick in. I started losing count. I was really hurting then.
15. Come on, stay with it. 16. Come on.
It just shows how amazing the, you know, different athletes are at different things.
Lewis Jetta, Not only fast, but very, very strong. 16 repetitions.
In the bench press challenge, I thought I'm going to get annihilated in this one.
Jamming up, push, breathe push, out, push, push. That's it, come on. Let's go.
I was stoked to just get above 10.
Push, 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 push.
Don't do too much weights, mate, do you?
No, not at all. Yeah. Not at all, really.
Yeah, so he's done well there.
Kurt Gidley was just, he was just insane. He bashed out the first 10.
Yeah. 11. 12.
Okay.
13. Come on, keep going. Okay. 14. There's 15. Good job. Good job. Keep going, Kurt. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. 17. Kick on, Kurt.
Go, push, push, push. 7-8, I think it was. 7-8,
three quarters.
Yeah,
three quarters. Doesn't count, the three quarters.
That's amazing. It's at 80% body weight, that's huge.
Phenomenal efforts from both Tannen and Kurt. The young gun with 14 reps. And the not-so-young gun pumps out the top score for all of the boys, 17. The results reflect the strength needed for the footy coach.
So the Ironman might not be as strong as the football athletes in this test because their sport is more an endurance event. The Ironman were relatively similar. Tammin actually was leading the group there, which was a really good result for him. And Simon found the test a little bit more challenging.
Now from strength to power.
So we saved the most difficult test for last, and that was the repeat sprint test.
This is James. He's going to take you through your paces.
All right, Kendrick, it's 6 10-second sprints at maximal effort with 20 seconds break in between each run. And the purpose of that test is to basically look at how powerful are the athletes.
It measures their power output. We look at it relative to their body weight.
You ready? All right. 3, 2, 1. Go, 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 go.
Push, push,
come on. Come on. 5 seconds. Go, go, go.
Drive.
Come on. Push it. 3, 2, 1. Job. Done. 20 seconds break.
Having the anaerobic sprint test last, I guess, was, that was tough because that was by far the hardest one.
Go, come on.
Push,
lift it up.
Come on.
Drive.
Jitter, he was able to maintain his power output throughout those six tests, so he had less fatigue.
Drive.
I figured I'd just go hard and try hold on.
And whee!
I just feel the pain, lactic acid built in.
The pain.
3, 2, 1.
Said go and I went for it.
Push. Come on, Tanner. Come on.
Got to like 8 seconds and I was like, oh God, I'm gonna fall off his bike. It's like you're paddling in slow motion. It's just weird.
Hit it really well. Probably had the highest peak power output.
You only have 20 seconds between each effort. You can't shake your legs out or anything like that. And that's where all the lactic acid is. It's just all in your legs. It's all built up.
Right now, their legs will be burning. They'll have difficulty continuing on with the test.
Keep going.
My quads were going probably before I started the test.
5 seconds. Drive. Done and stop. 3, 2, 1, stop. Good job.
Tannen and Kurt rang.